Issue 1, the eagle versus the bear.
The United States this week publicly criticized Russia's military action in the Transcaucasian nation of Georgia.
Bullying and intimidation are not acceptable ways to conduct foreign policy in the 21st century.
The Russian president hasn't kept his promise to abide by the terms of this ceasefire and have Russian forces withdraw. Russia is very clearly isolating itself. It's becoming more and more the outlaw in this conflict.
The U.S. criticism has been so sharp and unremitting, the Secretary of Defense, Robert Gates, has pointed to a possible enduring impact on the relationship between the two superpowers.
I do think that the tone of the relationship certainly has been changed by the actions that the Russians have taken in Georgia. And I think that it has prompted a fairly serious reevaluation in the United States about the breadth of the kind of strategic relationship and cooperation that we might be able to have with the Russians going forward.
Question. Assume that the cost of protecting Georgia is to alienate Russia. Is that in the United States' national interest? Pat Buchanan.
Well, you're talking about bringing Georgia into NATO as they're talking about bringing Ukraine into NATO. That would be insanity, John. First, we're not going to fight for Georgia, as is quite clear from the fact right now we're not doing anything militarily. And to commit yourself and give Georgia a war guarantee would be an act of folly, which would really start a second Cold War. The truth of the matter is the Georgians started this fight. The Russians finished it. The Georgians are not going to get back Abkhazia. They're not going to get back South Ossetia.
What's Abkhazia?
Abkhazia is a breakaway province, much larger on the coast of Georgia. South Ossetia.
Black Sea.
Yeah, South Ossetia is only 70,000. My guess is that's going to eventually be annexed by Russia. The United States ought to deal with the fact that they've had a setback and a humiliation, but not do something stupid and reactive and give a war guarantee to a country we're not going to defend. The greatest relationship or most important in the world just about is between the United States and Russia, and we ought not to imperil it because of this incident.
Hello.
Well, for an extremely lame duck administration, the rhetoric coming from the president and the Secretary of State have been extreme. I thought Secretary of Defense Gates has the relationship in context. There will be a cost here. But Pat is right. The provocation came from the Georgians. And the president of Georgia basically won election after a coup in which he promised to return the separatist provinces to Georgia, a promise that he's been trying to keep. And Russia was ready, perhaps overly ready, waiting, eager for the provocation. And they behaved in a brutish way. But the overreaction of the Bush administration, it seems to me, is also engineered in part to boost the Republican candidate, thinking that this may be the October surprise come a month or so early.
Overreaction by the United States is an absurd way of describing what is going on here. You have Russia, which is trying to reassert itself, create new spheres of influence, reestablish its old spheres of influence. They have invaded a tiny pro-Western democratic neighbor that happens to be very friendly to the United States, and the American president is supposed to sit by and just let the Russian tanks roll right through? That is absurd. The Russians over the last couple of years have been the chief provocateur of every major international incident that the United States finds itself in, with the exception of Al-Qaeda. That is that the United States did nothing when the Russians began supporting the Iranian nuclear program. We did nothing when the Russians began supporting the Syrian military program. We did nothing when the Russians resumed their flights of strategic bombers right off the coast of the United States. We said and did nothing because we didn't want to alienate them.
Thanks for the history lesson.
Let her finish.
It's about the provocateur in all of this. And to say that the United States of America is supposed to sit by and allow all of these provocations to go by and not
have
an adequate response is absurd.
When you taunt the Russian bear, you better make sure you have something make sure you have something other than blanks and rhetoric,
Clarence,
to fire.
I'm going to call you in one moment, but let's get back to this provocateur. Who was the provocateur? Was it Russia or was it Georgia?
The Russian-Georgian conflict has stirred a lot of analysis, but relatively little of it has focused on what provoked the Russian action. But one senator did allude to it Indiana Senator Dick Lugar, 32-year Senate veteran and former chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. The senator pointed out who attacked first, Russia or Georgia. Lugar says Georgia.
The facts are that our State Department advised Mr. Saakashvili not to attack because the Russians were armed, they were ready.
The former revered Soviet Union leader, Mikhail Gorbachev, whose perestroika and glasnost policies produced the 1991 independence of Georgia and Eastern Bloc nations, said this to Larry King, pointing to Georgia as the provocateur.
Russia could not avoid addressing this assault and this devastation and the killings of people, the devastation of the city. I don't know why it so happened that it is being presented that Russia invaded Georgia. This is really disinformation. This is all lies.
This is really disinformation to say that Russia was the provocateur. What do you think of all that?
Well, in fact, there is an argument that, is being made, an argument can be made, that President Saakashvili overplayed his hand, that he thought the United States was going to support him more strongly than we have, and as Pat says, more strongly than we are likely to do.
Well, he knows that the President of the United States has a policy of strategic encirclement of Russia.
Right.
Witness what we're doing in Poland. Witness right. what we are doing in the Czech Republic.
That's right, but we don't want to endanger, though, our economic relations, our commercial relations, Russian right. oil. Neither does Russia want to endanger their leverage with NATO, their right. their membership in the World Trade Organization that they're trying to get. There's a lot of diplomatic leverage that we can use here, and that Saakashvili could have used, but he didn't. He pushed harder, and suddenly he did provoke the big
Do
Russian
bear. Do
you
think that the president now understands that we have a different Russia than we had immediately? After the at the beginning of the Cold War?
You mean, is he ready to look into Putin's eyes again and read his soul?
Well, no. How far it has come with its development, its oil development, its gas development, it feeds Europe?
It is a different world now, and Georgia does have the only pipeline coming out of there that's not controlled by Russia, although militarily now that may have shifted.
Well, what is the level? To what extent do we give Russia a benefit of the doubt in as much as the provocation occurred by Saakashvili of Georgia?
Here's what, look. Saakashvili got what he deserved. That was stupid. And the Americans had to know it was coming and should have told him, stop, don't do this. We didn't do that. The Russians overdid it.
Well, there were three people from the State Department who told him that.
Well, the President of the United States should have got on the phone instead of fooling around with the volleyball players.
This is true. Saakashvili thought he had the president with him because the president had gone over there right. 2 years ago and said, I'm on your side.
Saakashvili, I don't care how much they love him or how, quote, democratic he is. The relationship with Russia is vital to the national security of the United States. And Abkhazia and South Ossetia are not.
Who has more nuclear weapons, Russia or the United States?
I think they're probably roughly equal.
They're roughly at parity. That's correct.
We got more.
Does that tell you something?
They're the second most powerful nation on earth. And look, you don't step on...
Do you remember when the president was asked to visit the Black Sea about 2 years ago or 3 years ago to visit with Putin? And Putin told him how obnoxious it was for us to put our missiles in Poland?
Sure, let me tell you.
And how painful it was, and against that...
John, here's what's going to happen. We put the missiles in Poland and also anti-aircraft missiles manned by Americans. Look for the Russians to put the S-300...
Can you blame the Russians? Can you blame the Russians?
Russians will put anti-aircraft missiles in Iran and Syria. You watch.
Now, what do you think of all that?
I find this whole conversation an out-of-body experience, that we're blaming the United States, the Western democracies, the Eastern European democracies, and the new democracy in Georgia for the fact that the Russian imperialist power is back, sending their tanks rolling across sovereign borders.
They were provoked to do so.
Let me tell you something. Those Eastern European leaders who were so worried about a resurgent Russia that they wanted, and by the way, the missile interceptors going into Poland are now at the request of the Polish government. Don't you think those leaders watching what's happening in Georgia, that now those fears were founded, that everybody wants to appease Russia?
Wait a minute.
Everybody wants to appease Russia, hoping that the crocodile doesn't eat them last.
And Al-Qaeda in Iraq now.
For heaven's sakes.
What's the way out of this crisis?
It's a question of reality.
What should Bush do now? What's the way out of the crisis, Pat Buchanan?
Well, what Bush is going to have to do is realize he's not going to reverse this thing. Quite frankly, the way for the United States after Bush is, let's call and demand free elections in Abkhazia, free elections in South Ossetia. Do they want to remain with Georgia? Where do they want to go?
What are the indications so far?
Well, look, they don't want any part of the Georgia.
They want their independence. That's what they want.
Well, Ossetia is too small for independence. It ought to go to Russia. Abkhazia can be independent.
Ossetia can handle independence. 70,000 people.
70,000 people?
It's about the size of Rhode Island. Look at Rhode Island, for heaven's sake.
It's like Bethany Beach,
more than 70,000, quickly.
I think the president should shut up and go away. He's a lame duck.